Go for it.
So according to a 2019 article with U.S. News, by law under our title, school districts double down on drug testing, targeting even middle schoolers, stated that nearly 38% of school districts test their students. And to bring that more into the local terms, an interview that we conducted with Dustin Riley on August 30th, 2019, about 732 students are enrolled here and 690 on the drug testing pool. And going back to that interview, Riley stated, and I quote, "We typically test once a month, sometimes twice, testing 15 people at a time. So if you do basic math, that's about 135 people a year tested if you do once a month, and 270 if you do twice a month. And even with that 270 people testing twice a month, that's still less than 40% of people getting tested from that pool. But it's even less because the same people get drug tested multiple times. But here at FC, it is completely random. There should be no stigma about it that drug testing isn't random, but it completely is 100% random. So to explain it, everyone gets a number. The number is shuffled, and then 15 people plus some alternates get picked to be in the drug testing. And the public opinion on drug tests, whether it should be in school or not, is completely divided. The public is completely divided with the drug tests. And some reasons are because drug tests can be cheated on, but they also, you know, lead kids to a drug-free life. But some also think that drug tests let kids become sneakier doing drugs, and you know, learn how they work and how long it's in your system. But today we're talking about the selections, benefits, and possession of drugs and drug tests.
So the first inherency that we're addressing is selection. So a little bit of background information on this. I know Kurt gave you the numbers, but everyone who is actively in school is in this pool. Yet it is mostly made up of athletes and people who are in extracurricular activities. And to dispel the rumor that drug testing targets athletes, as Kurt said, it is 100% random. 15 random numbers are shuffled and chosen, along with 10 random alternates. So by drug testing these students, it will deter them from doing this illegal activity, especially athletes, because they have a lot more to lose. They won't be able to play in their seasons or whatever. So according to a 2019 CNN article by Margaret Rice titled "Schools to Test for Nicotine in High School Students Involved in Extracurricular Activities," the Centers for Disease Control estimates more than 3 million high school students use vaping products. So by having more of these drug tests, it will lower this number by discouraging these kids to vape.
So with the randomness, is this randomness actually fair? Kerr and I have only been tested one time in our high school career, whereas Kelsey has been tested 5 times and Rachel has been tested none at all. So all high school students should be tested at least one time throughout their high school career. And why is this such a big deal? Well, it's a big deal because students who are actually doing the drugs could get a chance of never getting tested, and students who are not doing the drugs get tested multiple times. So that's taking away from his less than 50%, as Kurt stated, it making it even lower because the same students are getting tested. So kids can never get caught. And the benefits, like, it's really confusing because if we're doing this, we should be able to catch kids who are doing it. That's the whole purpose of it. And why are we really doing this? And I'm going to let Kelsey explain that.
What are the benefits of drug testing? Does it make the overall atmosphere / environment safer? Does it have negative effects? Does it lead kids to live a drug-free life? Starting with the pros and referring back to the atmosphere / environment, one of the benefits being our actions does reflect on the school as a whole. Let's say Brady, our varsity quarterback, fails his drug test. You gotta think, how will that reflect on your teammates, as well as a faculty member such as your coach or your principal? And speaking of a principal, our principal standpoint, I feel that from that standpoint, the principal would think you have to have a better image for our school. Overall, you have to have that kind of stand out because you are in charge. As Kurt mentioned, an article stated school districts doubling down on drug testing by Kaiser Health News in 2019 states parents say it gives kids a reason to say no to drugs and may identify those who need help. Leading into another perspective with cons, kids can be less involved in sports if one hears that one is just testing athletes, or they will not be involved in clubs such as extracurriculars because those can be taken away if tested positive. And ones can be less involved and more rebellious, knowing that you can bring vape juice to school just to take somebody off. So we can each another perspective.
Another one of our inherencies is the act of actually possessing the vape or the drug versus actually smoking or doing the drugs. So according to Mr. Riley, a positive does not show up on your record, so even if you have drugs in your system, it still will not go on your record. The only time it will actually show up in your record is if you fail 3 times, you'll be put under academic probation. But the reason for even being put under academic probation will not show up on your article. So possession does go on record, as Trinity will explain.
So as Rachel stated, possession of any drug, vape, jewel, etc. has way worse consequences than actually doing it. Now, I'm not saying go home and smoke a blunt because it's going to be better. No. What I'm saying is that you will receive immediate punishment, according to Mr. Riley, and it will go down on your record. And you could possibly go to jail, especially if you're in contact with it at school. And because you could get other kids doing it, and you'll get in trouble and all that. If you're 18 now, should you be able to purchase it and do it on your own time? This is a gray area in schools because Rushville took their school all the way up to court. This is from Mr. Riley too. Rushville took their school all the way up to court against a student because the student was 18 and in possession of nicotine and doing it, and he failed his drug test with nicotine. Well, he ended up losing in the case because you're setting an example for your school. So if you're failing it, even if you're 18, kind of sucks. Depends on every school, and I don't really know what to say about that because ours is kind of iffy. One of our own students, Kurt, got 2 days out of school suspension and couldn't go to the BLA conference just for possession of vape juice. And he said, and I quote, "Even though I had the vape stuff, I could have passed the drug test if they had given it to me. This is an issue because even kids who aren't doing it and may just be in possession of it, holding it for a friend, or getting worse consequences than people who are actually doing it."
So in conclusion, drug tests lead to a safer school and a safer school environment, but it also can lead to kids rebelling out against drug tests because teens obviously don't want to be drug tested. And there is a stigma that their drug tests aren't random and they target certain people. But here at FC, it's completely random. We have hard evidence of that. And when schools actually do target athletes, it deters the kids from actually participating in sports, not wanting to play them. But it also can lead the current athletes to live a healthy, drug-free life. And all this accounts for how divided the public is on these drug tests. But all in all, no matter what the fact, it's important if your high school has drug testing, to follow the rules of it. And it's even more important to live a drug-free life.
All right, thank you.